Hello and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hello and welcome. Okay, so in this video I'm doing a short square set with a jigsaw design with my neon gel paints. It was my stepsister's idea, probably because the jigsaw is used to raise awareness of autism and she has an autistic son. So I thought I'd have a go and see what I could do. I did look for inspiration and saw a picture similar to this. I don't know who it was that did it originally, so I can't credit them. But I didn't do it exactly the same anyway. So, yeah, so I'm just sticking some tips on. I prepped the tips that I've got in the nail grooves on practice hand. And now sticking some tips on. These tips are ones that are left over from my course that I did over a year ago now, before I qualified. They're very hooked, so I don't normally use them. I wouldn't use them on a client, but because it was a short square set, I thought I'd use them rather than just let them sit there going to waste. I'd use them because you can file them up from underneath, so that it comes out straight from the sidewalls, as you'll see me do. So yeah, so I'm filing now with my metal file, making sure the free edge is nice and straight, and like I said, filing up from underneath and getting rid of that bend or curve in the nail, in the tip, sorry. And that one was coming unstuck, so I just added a bit more glue and came back to it at the end with the filing. I'm also blending the tips in a little bit because they're really quite thick. And I didn't want that step there, so I blended the tips in a bit so that the acrylic would go on nice and smooth. And back to that index finger that I haven't filed yet because I had to stick the tip back down. And now I'm going in with, it's not Snow White, it's Coconut Milk by CJP. It's a nice soft white. I used white to build the nails because they're neon gel paints that I'm going to be using, and the white makes the colours pop. So it is a core powder, strength powder, so I didn't need to cap it in clear or anything like that. So it was easier basically than doing a clear set and then using gel polish to for the white. And as you can see, the temperature in my nail room was perfect when I did these nails yesterday. it wasn't too cold like it was the last time, so the acrylic wasn't running all over the place. It was a lot more controllable. Okay, so the acrylic has now set and I'm coming back in with my metal foil again, refining the shape. I'm just filing the side walls and the free edge, and then I come in with my e-file over the top of the nails. come in there with a carbide bit and just smoothing that surface of the nail out. Make sure there's no lumps or bumps or acrylic stuck under the free edge, which is why I was going underneath the nail there. And I'm now coming in with a matte top coat before I go in with the gel paints, just to protect the acrylic from any staining from the gel paints. And the way I did the jigsaw design, I divided each nail into four quarters with a different colour on each quarter, and then did the actual jigsaw bits, little round bits, going to the next jigsaw piece. Yeah, some of this, the filing and the prep of the tip in the nail grooves, I sped up quite a lot because obviously I've left everything in this video, so it would have been really long if I hadn't sped it up quite a lot, but I haven't sped it up as much on this bit, so you can see what I'm doing. Well, I'm doing the same on every now, so hopefully you don't get too bored watching me do that. I went slightly over the line there, which is why I did that. But then I realised I'm going to be going over it with a different colour anyway, so it doesn't really matter. So I left it as it was. These CJP gel paints are really quite opaque, so you only need one coat and it covers everything, so it's fine. It's my postman. Oh, something else coming through. Thank you, Mr. Postman. Okay, so coming in with a second colour, and each finger is a different colour. A different combination of colours, rather. Into the third quarter now. And between each new quarter that I do on the nails, I'm flash curing in the lamp, so the colours don't run into each other at all. In the last quarter now. Thank God I hear you say. And you see how well that smudge bit covers this blue. And there you go, you can't see it at all. Okay, so I'm now coming in with some black gel paint and a dotting tool just to do the, it's basically for the outline of those round bits. So after I've cured the black dots, I go in with the colour and do a slightly smaller dot over it so that you get like a black outline around it. It seemed easier to do it that way than trying to outline those little round dots. that black gel paint is quite thick and it was a bit stringy, and I had to do a bit of a clean-up operation a couple of times. Okay, so I'm now going to come in with the colour and just do a smaller dot in the middle of each of those black dots before I outline the actual puzzle pieces. Filling in any missing bits of gel paint as I go. I could just dance side of that little now, pinky now. Sorry about the camera going out of focus every now and again. It seemed to be focusing on my nearest hand rather than on the nails. And then it takes a moment to focus back onto the nails when I take my hand away. There's not a lot I can do about that, unfortunately. So now I'm coming back in with that black gel paint and just going around the outlines. Okay, so I'm curing that now. And now I'm coming in with some rubber base coat, just to even out the surface of the nail. Obviously, where I've used the dotting tool, there's little bumps. So I'm using the rubber base coat just to smooth it all over before I put the top coat on, so that the nails don't have those little bumps and they feel nice and smooth. And now I'm going in with the top coat. Hello, Sola. My cat Sola's just jumped up next to me. And there's the finished result. I hope you like them. I think they're really pretty. Nice and shiny and bright. Okay, and there's my reveal shot. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up and click the notification bell to be notified of future videos. Thanks for watching, appreciate it. Bye.